Today, we will using Adobe XD to mimic Google search drop-down menu. If you wish to know how we do this, continue to watch this video. This is the interface of Google. When we tap of the search column, they will have a drop-down with lists. So, we will now copy this design to our artboard to start with this hover drop-down effect. Bring in the Google logo. Using rectangle tool to draw a rectangle box. Rounded up the box by dragging the circle at the corner. Untick the border selection, and tick the drop shadow function. Bring in the search icon, and place it on the search box. Using type tool, type the sentence, search Google or type a URL. Align it at the center of the box. Then bring in the search by voice icon. Select the search box together with the three items on it, click Align and Ctrl plus G to group them together. Select the search box group, Ctrl plus K or press the plus button here to create component. This is how the search box look like when in default state, where we do not apply any action on it. To see what we need in the hover state, we can check at the Google Chrome browser. This is where all the elements are in default state. When tap on it, a drop-down menu list appear. This is what the hover state will include when we place our mouse click on each of the selection, there will have a gray bar and cross sign appear. This is another hover state on this selection. So, now, we apply this function to our drop-down menu artboard. Select the search box group, add hover state by pressing the plus button. Make sure hover state is selected, expand the search box. Change the rounded edges out of the box to 20 point. Draw a gray box using rectangle tool. Follow the screenshot as above, pick the gray color and drag in the clock icon. Group 13 is the clock icon. We can check at the properties here, the newly added clock icon is not in the component. Ctrl plus X to cut and Ctrl plus V to paste the icon into the same component. Using type tool to type the web page address. Draw a cross sign icon using line tool. Ctrl plus G to group the gray box and the elements on top of it together. Select the gray box and the cross sign, reduce its opacity to 0. Now, we can click the preview button on top to check the function. In hover state, the search Google or type a URL text is unseen, so we reduce its opacity to 0 in hover state. There is another hover effect to do on this sub-menu, click on it, and add another component. Click on the pencil icon, it will automatically create a main component outside the artboard. Click on plus button add hover state. In hover state, turn back the gray box opacity and cross icon to 100%. Now, we preview again. When mouse click hover on top of the submenu text, the gray selection box will then appear. We can duplicate this submenu list by using the repeat grid here. When tap on it, a green handle appears. Drag the handle to the bottom. Reduce the gap between the column by dragging to zero. Preview again to check the result. The animation is not very smooth. We can change to prototype mode, and change the action type from auto animate to transition. Now we preview again, the animation finally looks smooth now. The Google Hover drop-down menu is done. But, if we want to make the submenu list scrollable, we can expand the list till outside of the search box. And press the vertical scroll at the properties panel here. Adjust both the handle on top and bottom, ensure we can only see the list within the search box. Check at the preview column, and yes, we can even have the scroll function here.